Thanks for joining us today. As you are aware, we're today announcing our candidates for the presidency of the European Parliament. But first, I will hand over to our president of GUE NGL, Gabi Zimmer, just after one moment of untangling the headphones.
Guten Tag, meine.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, we have to sort out the mess that EPP has left behind. Hopefully we'll manage. Yes, there we go. Looks like we're ready to start now. So, welcome everyone. I'd like to take this opportunity on behalf of our group to very briefly introduce our candidates. But first, I'd like to talk about the process in these presidential elections. Now, for us, the criticism of current developments in the European Parliament is mainly comprises of the fact that the Parliament is currently not really a stalwart of democracy. We think that we need to set an example if we want to promote democracy, and over the past 2.5 years we have seen a grand coalition between two groups, and this coalition has primarily focused on the European Parliament being used as a tool to support the European Commission and to organise the majorities in Parliament so that the two main groups can basically decide things among themselves. Many debates have been simply removed from the table, the rights of MEPs have been limited, and this is one of the main reasons why we are now saying that we are going to put our own candidates forward for the European Parliament presidency, and we will exercise our rights by also putting forward a candidate for the vice president. And we are very clearly stating to all other groups, whoever wants our votes for a decision must prove that this grand coalition in the European Parliament no longer exists. All of these people who claim that this grand coalition no longer exists are simply part of this coalition that's been going on for 2.5 years, and we don't understand why today we should simply start believing overnight that the political views have changed. And I think that this is very clear from the discussions on the rules of procedure. We're currently undergoing discussions on a report in changes to the rules of procedure, and it's mainly been determined by the Grand Coalition here in the Parliament, and we're not going to accept that. So we are now making this call for everyone putting themselves forward as candidate for Parliament President. Now, that was just my introduction, and of course I'd like to introduce to you Eleonora Forenza now, who represents an Italian party in the European Parliament, and it's her first time in this legislative period. Eleonora is a feminist. For many years she has been working actively within the movement for the self-determination of women, and since she has been a member of the European Parliament she has been also trying to increase the voice of social movements in the European Parliament. She's gained a lot of experience. She has also worked as an activist, for example, on the subject of a minimum income, and has also dealt with precarious employment, among other issues. Eleonora knows what she's talking about. She was an academic, and she researched, and she also had to live under these precarious working conditions. With Eleonora, we are putting forward a feminist from Southern Europe, and we think this brings an important perspective for policy in the European Union, and I think that this is something that's been underrepresented to date. So this is Eleonora, she'll be representing us, and I would also like to introduce to you Dimitris Papadimoulos. Many of you know him already. For some time he has been a member of the European Parliament now, between 2004 and 2009, and then for a short period he sat in Greece's national parliament, and since 2014 He has been back in the European Parliament representing Syriza. He is already vice president, and we think that he has done a very good job as vice president. Beyond the borders of our group, he has also had recognition of his work, which is why we are re-presenting him as a candidate. So I think that with Eleonora and Dimitris, we are putting forward a very good team for preparations for the plenary next year. So that's all I've got to say for my part, of course. You have to decide now who has the floor, so I'll give the floor back to you.
Okay, I'll call on Eleonora, of course, to begin, and we have about 2 minutes just so that there's enough time for us for questions. Thanks.
Buongiorno a tutti.
Good morning, everyone. I'd like to thank Gabby very warmly for her kind words. The entire GUI NGL group I'd like to thank as well for putting me forward as a candidate for President of the European Parliament. It's a great honour for me. It would mean a great deal of responsibility as well. I spoke in the House just now on the issue that Gabby was mentioning on the changes to the rules of procedure. I think this is a symbol of how the Grand Coalition, which runs this European Parliament and which has adopted austerity policies and neoliberal policies in Europe, they are now adopting a report that would actually restrict the area for democratic practice in the Parliament. That's clear from this proposal they're making for the European Parliament for the rules of procedure. I think that our future has to involve broadening the arena for democratic debate, and we have to improve the functioning of the European Parliament. Parliament has to be the voice of individuals. It has to be an open people where different social movements can express themselves and we can reflect the struggles that are going on. Otherwise, if we tighten up the rules in this way, we will just be rubber stamping decisions taken by the council and rubber stamping decisions which help the big economic lobbies. As Gabby has said, I am a convinced feminist. This is a very important point. I have had my experience, and I think this is be part of my candidacy for the European Parliament presidency. We had a debate recently in plenary about a Europe in which one third of women still suffer physical violence or are subject to psychological violence. One third of women, and I was saying just to Gabby just now that so far only there have only been two female presidents of the European Parliament, and I think it's not. It's not just a question of asking for more seats for women if we've got masculine policies. I think we as women can rewrite politics, and we can rewrite the way we participate in politics. I am a feminist, and I come from Southern Europe. That's a very important point for me because the whole of our group and like all the delegations in our parliamentary group, we want to work against austerity policies. We want to combat neoliberal policies. We want to remind everyone that it's the banking debts that have strangled the European economy and strangled and stifled the economies of Southern Europe. Thank you.
Thanks, Eleonora. I'll now hand over to Dimitris Papadimoulis, the candidate for the vice presidency.
Θα ήθελα να ευχαριστήσω την Ευρωομάδα.
Thank you. I would like to start by thanking the GUI NGL group for having placed its trust in me once again. I was vice president, or I've been president of the European Parliament since July 2014. My responsibilities included gender equality, relations with trade unions, the Council of Europe, national parliaments, issues pertaining to democracy and transparency. I think those are probably the most left-leaning issues dealt with by the Bureau. I never expected to be given responsibility for relations with NATO or the IMF, for example. Gabby was quite clear, as was Eleonora, and I don't really think I have much to add. I want the European Parliament to achieve greater transparency and democracy in the way in which it functions. I think we need more democratic pluralism. We need a European Parliament which is stronger and which is visible to the citizens who elect us. This is why I believe that the European Parliament should figure more highly in the institutional setup in the European Union. The European Parliament can't continue with business as usual. Most major decisions taken in the European Union result from a preliminary agreement between the EPP and the Socialists, and both the Liberals and indeed the Socialists now tell us that the time has come to bring an end to these coalitions. At the same time, the EPP is telling us that we need a grand coalition so as to sideline the populists who want to undermine and destroy Europe. So we have to avoid lumping together our own democratic left-wing group, a group which is in favour of a democratic and social Europe, on the one hand, with the fascist and populists who want to bring Europe to its knees.
The minutes we have remaining, I will open the floor to questions. Are there any questions? Hi.
Jurek Kuszkiewicz for Le Soir. Question to all of you on the presidency, on the election for the presidency. Mr. Pittella today emphasized very strongly in front of us that the Grand Coalition, he never called it that way, so in any way whatever existed does not exist and will not exist anymore, and he is calling for now advocating for a big progressist coalition. Anyway, he didn't say coalition, but that's what he meant. Do you consider yourself as naturally part of the leftist progressive coalition, of which the Social Democrats are, of course, a big part? And in this case, would you, in fine, support rather a president from the SND than from the EPP?
Okay. Ja, wir haben ja nun inzwischen in den zweieinhalb Jahren.
What we've learned over the past 2.5 years is that the SND is not automatically on the side of progress. For 2.5 years, it has been in this grand coalition supporting Juncker, supporting austerity policy. So, from the very beginning, we have agreed within our group, firstly, for this reason, we'll put forward our own candidate. And for us, it was completely clear, and this was clear several years ago when Mr. Schulz became candidate for the first time, that we could support this, but ultimately left-wing policies and democratic politics is going to have less of an influence, perhaps, in future than we would hope. Now, we can't say to the Social Democrats that only Mr. Schulz was responsible for the Grand Coalition. S&D were also responsible. Now, if they're saying, let's put an end to it, that's great. But, of course, we want to have very specific evidence of this. We want to see specific actions. Now, as part of a left-wing democratic position, we want to see, of course, an alliance in Parliament, but on specific issues. And we're not going to automatically take a particular position on a particular issue. We want to look at every individual question, whether it's austerity policy, Greece, the way in which we deal with Portugal, Italy, Spain. We want to find out what the details are. We want to know about migration policy as a whole. And we've got a number of other positions where we say, here in the Parliament, we need to send out a democratic signal that we don't just say, OK, we need to be more transparent, but that we are also prepared to listen. to go out to people and to try and understand why there is this real gap between citizens and Europe. We want to really win Europe back for the people. That's what our goal is, but we will not be agreeing to any kind of deal whereby we agree to a particular basic line for 2.5 years. We don't want to be excluded from the debates. We want to be involved in the debates from the very start, and we don't want to simply have these put to us as foregone conclusions because the Grand Coalition has come up with some kind of deal before the Conference of Presidents, and then it doesn't matter whether we are in favour or not because they've got a majority nonetheless. And I think that we really need to tackle this in very terms of very specific measures.
Well, I completely agree with what Gabby was saying. After 2.5 years of facts, evidence where we've seen that the socialists supported and were an integral part of this grand coalition, and they supported austerity policies. I mean, words are not enough. We've seen the facts. And I'd like to add something to what Gabby was saying just now. And I've said again, I agree with her. There was a referendum in Italy just a week ago, and the SND candidate supported the positions of the Renzi government and conducted politics that were fully in line with austerity policies, and jobs have been reformed, so they're now more insecure, and the schools are being reformed along neoliberal lines, and Renzi wanted to reform the constitution in such a way he would weaken the parliament. Pittella supported this constitutional reform, so we don't believe at all that he's different, that he's going to represent a break with the grand coalition, that he's going to move away from that.
Συμφωνώ και προσυπογράφω όσα είπε απαντώντας η πρόεδρος της ομάδας μας, η Γκάμπι Τσίμερ.
Thank you. I'd very much echo what our president Gabby Zimmer said. We are open to debate with all political groups, with the exception of the fascist extreme right. We are willing to enter into cooperation on the basis of shared objectives. We've always had an open mind when it comes to cooperation and discussion. However, nobody can count on our support. We need clear demonstrations, we need evidence that things are actually changing.
Okay. Were there any quick last questions? No? Okay. Thanks, everybody, for joining us today.
Grazie a tutte e tutti.
Thank you, Gabby.